Hello everyone, my name is Mythrell and welcome back, so let's continue straight away. So we're still in a stutter, it seems. Oh, that's probably right. Right. Above us. So they have some kind of tunnel experiment here going on here.
Oh, dude. Come on, you're at work.
Adventurous religious singles dating website. Pure thrills for the pure of heart. Find your soulmate. Meet the one he meant for you. Abstain together. Enjoy the tension. There's room for all in the closet of the Lord. Yeah. So we got more emails from Paul Serene. To Paul Serene from Cara Aveiro. I don't think I've heard that name before. Time Machine Core. Paul, the Time Machine Core has successfully been transported to the HQ and installed in the Monarch time machine frame on top of on the top floor of the tower. The crew is getting restless. They really need some insight into the next steps. I understand the details of your plan remain confidential for a reason, but any information you can give us would be extremely helpful. Kara. Kara, thank you for the update. We do not require the time machine to be activated in the near future, but from this point forward I want technicians on standby. Our plan requires absolute control. That is what the machine represents. More than anything, we want to protect the machine from falling into hands of our enemies. We have to deny them from opportunity to disrupt our plans. We may not be able to change the past, but if my travels have proven anything, it's that the past can help us better prepare for the steps to come. Those steps will be made clear for you very soon. Paul Serene. Okay. Gonna check the upstairs next.
Garage. Sounds like the way out of this place.
Okay, so I'm supposed to go in that way, so I'm not gonna go there. There yet. Alright, it's right here. These things are actually pretty well hidden, so... Yeah, I think I missed a bunch of them on the previous map as well. But I don't think they're necessarily that important. Lifeboat presentation. The lifeboat located at Monarch HQ. Access sealed until activated. Completely stutter-proofed. Maintained with chronon particles sourced from ground zero. Particle flow directed by the CFR. Twofold purpose. Guarantee survival of human race. / find a way to restart time. Limited capacity. Personnel chosen based on vital skills. Complete discretion required. Note. Change of plans. Mr. H will give the LB activation prep speech instead of Mr. S. S will interrogate Joyce. Okay. It's down here. Nothing, I suppose. So we will go for the garage. Uh-oh. Oh, that's another door. Okay. For some reason I thought that red glow meant something else. Oh, we have one right here. How many do we actually have? So I have 3 upgrade points available. And most of these take 6. Yeah, or 4. This actually could be nice. Yeah.
All I had to do was make it through the garage. Seems simple enough.
Oh. This is actually a terrible weapon. I suppose this is the easiest way to... Oh! Take care of them! Unless you somehow end up missing them. Oh yeah, more coming. Okay. Should really use other abilities as well, just... This is just so good. Oh yeah.
Well, that's not gonna make my life any easier. There's gotta be a way out of here.
The heavy pistol is so much better.
Damn. The alarm must have locked everything down. Maybe I can turn it off.
Doesn't seem to be that much of a choice we're on. Have to go. Was that something? Oh, it was sad. It was sad, okay. Oh, I can get here, okay?
Oh shit! Okay.
That took care of it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, sure. This light machine gun is actually pretty good weapon, so...
Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
They say Hash getting shot at was an insider job. Might create a window for us, but Serena's looking for you. Remember what we said. I'll keep him occupied, but switch to the Monarch frequency to make sure you stay out of his crosshairs.
Okay. I'll see you at the party.
Okay.
Just give up.
Oh, one of big boss. Oh, Jesus. He scared me. Oh, well, he's done. Was another empty weapon. Another man down. Kinda getting confusing. Okay.
Thank God. That's the last of them.
I should actually pick up ammo here. So do I have ammo? No. And this one does, okay.
Am I right? Well, let's take a little look at the weather. It's a nice fall evening with clear skies and that lovely crisp autumn air. Why can't be better than that?
I need the exact coordinates for Joyce ASAP. Monarch Actual is moving in to intercept.
This is Home Guard 5. Just spotted a movement entering the tunnel system outside the party grounds.
Beth?
On my way.
He took out my entire squad. Requesting immediate back.
What the heck is going on?
Yeah.
I could see the mansion where the gala was. I had to find a way to get there.
Oh. So, yeah, it's starting to look like the time egg is ready to pop.
Alright.
I could see the energy field of another Monarch Chronon dampener. It would drain my powers. I'd have to find a way to shut it off.
And here's the drone, okay. Can I actually do something here? I guess not. Oh! I should probably jump. Oh man. I hope we get right back to that. Okay. At least the save point was on a point this time.
My powers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful.
What the heck is this?
Somebody!
Where is this? Oh. So where is this dump? Probably I cannot hit that car. What the heck? Really? Oh, carbine rifle. This is something new. Right, it's right here.
Yeah, now we're talking.
Great. One of these big guys. The kind of guy I have to shoot in the back. Kind of looks like. I'm gonna try this. Or not. Apparently I kept pressing the wrong button. Yep.
You were headed for the party. What was your plan?
I needed to get to Dr. Amaral before the stutter ended and Monarch found out I was coming.
What do we have here? Oh. Okay. Some kind of truck.
There's gotta be a way to get past that gate.
Oh, we couldn't get in. Okay. My bad. I don't think there's anything else for me to pick up, but I'm gonna check it anyway. Yeah, there's ammo. Oh, don't tell me that we didn't pick that one up there. Well, not much I can do about it anymore. So let's get this thing done. It's kind of weird how these games go, that the later you are, the less there is story, more action. Wait, what? What is the point of this? Jump from here. Oh! Almost. I don't know, something here feels off. I think the V-Sync is kind of making the controls to be a little bit sticky. But it turns out that I cannot disable the V-Sync because then the DX Story cannot record the game, which is kind of bad.
This is the only tunnel entrance Joyce could have entered through.
Secure the exit. I'm going in alone.
So sir, sure you don't want support?
We've seen what Jack can do. I'm the only one who can stop him. If he gets to the mainland, we lose him for good. Secure the exit.
So this is a future event, I suppose. I'm just walking past everyone. Oh. Where is that? It must be the one all the way back there. I think.
Beth should be here somewhere. Need to get to her before the stutter ends.
Shocked text message. Holy fuck! Somebody took a shot at Hatch. I don't know what the fuck is going on. Cows aren't going through. Get back to me and tell me you're safe. Okay. Oh.
Sir, just... I know he explained this to me, but... Let me just confirm. Mr. Hatch really wants me to shoot you.
He wants you to shoot at him. And he wants it to be convincing. Your exit is as we've discussed. Get to your position, blend in. They'll think you're responding to what just went down. The blind spot you'll need has been prearranged.
I know the plan, I just don't get it.
You don't have to get it. You just have to do it and keep your mouth shut. This is way above your pay grade, son.
Yes, sir.
He arranged his own assassination? What the fuck?
Yep.
A traitor fired shots during Mr. Hatch's speech. I assume this was Beth Wilder.
But we both know it wasn't. Hatch wanted to send Monarch into a state of disarray. Best way to avoid blame? Look like the target.
We have multiple of these things. Oh. The heck? How do I get up there? Oh, I don't have to get up there, right? I'm actually gonna buy something. So yeah, this is pretty cool. I have to say. Fiona cocktail sword. Get Charlie drunk enough to access the lab. Yeah, nice. Leaving that on a paper.
Alright, that's it.
5 out of 8. This is kinda bugging me that it's still showing up. It must be the one up there, right? Yeah, it points exactly there. Well, maybe not. I suppose it could be on the beach, but how do you even get there? No, it's definitely out there. Okay. So maybe we did miss it. It's a shame. My screenplay part 2. Bruce Livingston. Oh my god, okay. Hey Sophia, still haven't got any notes back from you on the first half of my screenplay. But I'm finished the second half now. So I'll send it your way. Let me know what you think. Time Knife, written by Bruce Livingston. Act 2. Bruce has just had his best friend killed by his boss, Paul Marine. Bruce now has a time knife that sends things through time if he stabs them. He's going to Paul Marine's wedding now to tell his girlfriend, Sophine, not to marry him because he's a real city guy. Int wedding building day. It is a wedding. Paul Marine and his girlfriend Sophine are getting married. Sophine is real attractive. If most girls are ham sandwiches, then she is a 16-pound steak. I'm actually not familiar with these markings or what they. How are you are supposed to say? 16 ounces probably. Yeah, that's more likely. I mean, 16-pound steak would be a huge. Right. Bruce enters the wedding building. Bruce, stop! Sophine! Bruce, I'm so happy that you came! Bruce, you can't marry Paul Marine. He's a real city guy. Paul Marine, he's lying! Bruce, I'm not. He killed my best friend with time bullets.
But that's impossible. Time travel doesn't exist yet.
That's what they want us to think, but I actually have a knife that is also a time machine and sends people through time when I stab them.
I want to believe you, but that doesn't make sense.
I will prove it. Bruce grabs Sophine's mom. Here's a bunch of money for lottery tickets. Bruce gives Sophine's mom a bunch of money for lottery tickets. He stabs her with the time knife, but gently, not violently, just so that she will travel through time. She disappears. Sophie's mom enters the wedding building. She is now wearing different clothes. Sophie's mom is right, he stabbed me gently with a time knife and I was sent to the past. He also gave me a bunch of money which I used to buy a lottery ticket that I knew would win, and now I have $1 million. You helped my mom become rich.
Thank you, Bruce.
Bruce. You made me rich the first moment I saw you. Rich in my heart, with love.
Sophie?
I always love you most, but Paul Marine and I already just got married.
Paul Marine, you're too late.
Wedding minister, or is he?
The minister pulls off his mask.
He's actually George Washington. George Washington. Bruce knew you were getting married, so he stabbed himself and traveled to the past, then stabbed me so that I would be sent to this time. I then pretended to be a wedding minister for the ceremony, but I am actually not a minister at all, which means the marriage isn't official.
Sophine, you did all this for me, Bruce?
Yes, I stabbed George Washington because I love you. Also, the man you were about to marry wasn't actually Paul Marine.
Paul Marine takes off his mask.
It's Slobo, Bruce's best friend. Bruce, this is actually a fake wedding. I saved Slobo's life and then had him disguise himself as your boyfriend to make this look real, but it was actually a test to see if we were meant to be.
Sophine, the only thing meant to be is your death.
Sophine pulls out a gun. She pulls out her mask. It's the real Paul Marine.
Bruce, but how?
Paul Marine. I followed you to the past using my time bullets and discovered your plan to marry Sophine, so I already married Sophine in the past. She didn't want to, but then I saw her this baby.
Paul Marine reveals a baby.
Paul Marine, I told her that this baby was actually our baby from the future and that I used time bullets to travel with that baby back to the past to show her that we had a family together in the future. But in reality, it's just a baby I stole that isn't mine.
Bruce, then whose baby it is?
The real Sophine enters wearing futurist pants and shirt.
Sophine, ours.
Bruce, are you Sophine from the future?
Sophine.
Yes,
you are very quick to understand things. I came to the past to tell you that in the future you and I got married,
Bruce. We had a very active and highly satisfying sex life, which led to the birth of our future child, Uruguay.
That is the baby that Paul Marine is holding. He stole our baby.
Bruce,
why? Josephine. Palmer stole our baby and then traveled to the past so that he could use the baby as a lie to trick younger me to marry him instead of, by saying that it was actually the baby that he would have with me in the future. The past version of me believed him, and because of that I married Palmarine instead and no longer ever marry you at all. Slobo. Oh man. Palmarine, it's over, Bruce. We're married. Bruce, until death do you part. Bruce pulls out the time knife. Palmarine pulls out his gun with the time bullets inside. They have the best fight of any movie ever. At the end, Bruce has Palmarine with a knife to his neck. Bruce, it has been a slice.
What the?
this is just too good. Bruce lifts his knife up to cut Palmarine. Palmarine, you won't get me this easy. Palmarine aims the gun at himself and shoots himself 30 times. The clip is bigger than a regular pistol. No shit. Paul disappears, but then 30 Palmarines enter. Palmarine. I shot myself 30 times so that I was sent to many different times at the same time, which meant there was 30 of me. Or there were 30 of me. Now we are all here to kill you, Bruce, which means that each of you has a time bullet inside of you. Palmarine, of course, but I made sure that we were all shot in areas that have no vital organs, and we will get the bullets removed after we kill you. Bruce, unfortunately for you, I traveled to the past earlier and took your gun and added an electric charge on each of your time bullets. I control the electric charge with this handheld detonator. Palmarine, no! Bruce, yes, it is quite shocking. Yeah. Bruce presses his detonator. All 30 Palmarines are electrified from the inside. Their skin peels open all over like sausages that are left on the barbecue for too long that peel open all over. The Palmarines all die. Bruce, consider this my resignation. Uruguay, goo goo gaga, Slobo, oh yeah, George Washington, God bless America. Bruce and Sophine make out. Sophine waits for a few seconds for the audience to stop applauding before saying her next line. Sophine, congratulations, you passed the test. Bruce, what test? Sophine, we always believed you were the chosen one, so we traveled to the past to test you and make sure. We now believe you are ready to fight the ultimate villain from the future. Bruce, okay. Slobo, who is the ultimate villain? Sophine, his name is Palmarine. Bruce, but I just killed Palmarine. Sophine, no, the Palmarine you have known this whole time has actually been an actor from the future that we paid to play Palmarine for the test. The actual Palmarine is exactly the same, but he lives in the future. Bruce, he was an actor, which means my job was fake as well. Sophine, yes, that is the only reason why you were kept in a low-level position for so many years without a single promotion. And it appeared that people didn't give you the respect that you clearly deserve, because in reality you are the chosen one. Bruce, it all makes sense now. Sophine, we must travel to the future. Are you ready? Bruce, looks like it's time to find out. Oh man, this is fantastic. Bruce puts on his shades. George Washington waves the American flag. End of movie. Bruce Savage will return in Time Knife 2, The Reckoning. Yeah, it was pretty good. Okay, so I actually completely forgot where I was going. Thanks to this time knifing. Here we have some art, I suppose.
Beth was key to pulling off the mission. I needed to get to her before going any further.
Right here, okay. Oh! Right, that thing is in the process of crashing into the office right now. Wait, what? To go down there. Okay. I suppose I kinda skipped some part here.
Shooting up half a puzzle amusement park.
Yeah, well, Monarch does. I don't think my cover's gonna last.
Yeah, well, I don't think it would do much good for the next part anyway.
Okay, Dr. Amaral's somewhere inside the mansion. Let's go grab her. Bit of luck, we can be gone before anybody notices.
Okay, lead the way. What's our plan once we grab her?
There's a boat dock right outside the mansion.
Okay, we can make that work.
Oh, shit! Oh, that drone!
It's in the wrong place at the wrong time. Literally.
Jack, Dr. Amaral's in there. We need to get her out before time kicks back.
Okay.
Wait. Let's go get Dr. Amaral.
Oh. I need to wait her to get here, right?
Jack, get her moving before time kicks back in and that drone turns us into paste.
Get to it, Doctor.
Wait, what? Oh no, that's gonna be good. It's really happening. You're Jack Joyce. You're here to kill me.
No, but you're coming with us. We need your expertise.
No.
I'm not asking.
It's collapsing.
Come on, move. Ah!
Okay. Where's the damn boat?
It's right there.
Okay, go! Get her on the boat, I'll keep you.
Come on, Doctor!
Oh, hurry up!
You'll never get away with this.
Shit.
Get in!
It's Joyce! Somehow we got right past us! Go, let them escape! Somebody call me Supreme!
Okay.
Take care of it. You get going the second you can, okay?
This is actually pretty good rifle, apparently.
That's all.
There's still way too much firepower. These assholes are gonna sink us if you don't take care of them first.
Leave it to me.
Didn't mean to use that power, but... I missed, like, 30 meters.
Thanks for the heads up.
Oh. I'm not going that way.
Holy shit, it's Joyce! Reloading! Fire support! Get out! Ah, son of a...
I think that's one of the guys I need to get behind of him. I really like this rifle. Or maybe not. Guess we will find out. Oh shit.
Fucker down.
Yep. It's not. Oh. Fuck's sake, that was huge mistake. Forget completely about that turret in the back. Now we need to do that all again.
Jack, they're closing the gate. We'll be sending guns here until she gets it open for us.
I'll take care of it. You get going as soon as you can, okay?
Come on.
Firepower around. These assholes are gonna sink us if you don't take care of them first.
Speak to me.
You have a decent range on this. But not really. I need to stop pressing shift when I want to run.
That was close.
I guess that's one of the ways to do that. Okay. Actually able to run behind it. Yeah, I suppose I do have ammo on it, okay? Does not look like there's anything here. There's a dude inside. Somehow we've missed him.
Need to open that gate.
What about you?
You're clear. Go.
I can swing by.
Oh, that's a cool boy.
No, just go. We went to all this trouble to grab her. Beth, I'm counting on you to keep her alive. Make my own way out.
My plan was simple. There's a bridge to the mainland. I'd fight my way through anything Monarch would throw at me and steal a car, drive it back to the swimming pool.
Just remember, we need your ass alive for the next part.
Okay, so they're shooting. Okay, he was right at my face. Probably snapping a little bit more than they anticipated you would do. Oh shit, I can do that. Okay. He's dead. Nope. Where's this other guy?
Let's move up. Holy shit!
It's right behind me. I can take hits. Maybe I keep missing it or something. Although I suppose it's out of ammo.
With Beth and Dr. Amaral clear, it's time for me to get gone.
That's limited
with that,
range.
I need wheels.
Are we gonna steal Paul's car? Really?
Okay.
I mean,
time to get a ride out of here.
Right there, okay. Oh yeah, we're right at the same place. I didn't even recognize this place.
Valet parking. Beloved by car thieves everywhere.
Oh. Sergeant, yeah. Okay. So, I got the video here and see you on the next episode. Bye.